At India Hikes, as part of our Green Trails initiative, we collect a lot of waste from the mountains. It's from the slopes, from the villages, markets around, our own waste. So there's a lot that goes into actually managing this waste. We are at Lohajang, the base camp of the Rupkun Trek. We'll show you a little bit about how we manage our waste. This is just an example. This happens across all our base camps, whether in Himachal, Uttarakhand, Kashmir, West Bengal or Sikkim. Here's what we do.
Green Trails is not just about picking up litter from the mountains. It's a lot to do about how you manage the waste that you get from the mountains. And I want to give you a sense of perspective here. What we do at Green Trails is we segregate this waste. Now, segregating waste, people think you sort out the waste. It's not that. Now, segregating waste is a very, very back-breaking job. Just to give you an idea, 1 kilo of waste takes about an hour to segregate into three categories. That is something that you can upcycle, something that you can recycle, and something where none of these is possible, and then you have to send it down to the landfill. Now, what we try to do is that the landfill waste must be as little as possible, and the upcycling waste must be as high as possible, because that adds value to the waste that you get out.
There is a lot of waste that gets collected at our campsites on a daily basis. This includes the waste that trekkers collect on the trail, the waste that comes from the different dabas around the campsites, as well as the waste that we generate on a daily basis. All of these wastes are not just segregated as dry and wet waste, but we go a little further and segregate the dry waste even into three different categories: recyclables, non-recyclables and paper and cardboard.
ऊपर से जो भी हमारे जीटी वाले और हमारे जो ट्रैकर्स हैं वो ये प्लास्टिक जो ये रिसाइकलिंग वाला प्रोडक्ट है जो भी है ये गारपेक्स वगैरह इनको कलेक्शन करके वो वाहन हमारे म्यूल्स द्वारा वाहन खच्चर में लाते हैं वहाँ से मैं यहाँ बेस कैंप लोहाजिंग तक लाने का काम मैं करता हूँ और इसमें ये हमारे साथ बाकी मेरे ये जो स्टाफ है इंडिया हाइक्स के वो लोग हमारे साथ हेल्प करते हैं
Once the waste comes down, we further segregate it again. The recyclables are further segregated into bottles, plastic bottles, metals, as well as hazardous waste and e-waste. Once these are all segregated, each of these waste is taken to the Khabadiwala and is given away to them. The non-recyclable waste is again further classified into clean plastic as well as things that we cannot do anything with. The things that we cannot do anything with gets down to the landfill, while the clean plastics, we use it in two ways. One, we use it for bottle bricks. The other, we use it as stuffing for our eco pillows. These plastics are cleaned very much before they are being used for either of these. At our base, we not just collect the waste that comes from our treks, but we also take in the waste that comes from the different villages around our treks. But we do understand that this is not a long-term solution. So we've already started working on creating awareness amongst our locals to reduce the waste at its source.
मतलब इससे पहले तो ना कूड़ा जगह जगह में कूड़ा रहता था मतलब बगीचों में मतलब इकट्ठा करके वहीं रख देते थे हमारे गांव के लोग ना और जिस मतलब अब जो है इंडिया से वाले आए तो मतलब जगह जगह का कूड़ा उठाना मतलब शुरू किया तो मतलब अच्छा वातावरण हुआ गंदगी भी नहीं हुई अच्छी हवा मिलती है मतलब पॉलीथीन तो जो है प्रदूषण फैलाता है
जस्ट इमेजिन वी हैव ब्रॉट डाउन 21,000 किलोज ऑफ वेस्ट व्हिच इज 21 टन्स ऑफ वेस्ट एंड थिंक ऑफ द मैन पावर इन्वॉल्वड And all this manpower has been put in by all our people over there in the mountains, the trekkers, our staff, our mountain staff, the villagers. A lot of people are involved in this backbreaking task. And the upcycling waste, which now people have now converted into livelihood, because once you have upcycled it, it adds value to the waste. Then the recycled waste, which we send it down to, somebody who can use that as a livelihood, the Khabadiwalas in the mountains. Who gratefully take this waste because you know what, now they can earn something out of it. So we send it to them. So it adds another revenue source for these people. And then as little as possible, we send it down to the landfills, which goes all the way down to Dehradun. And then we do it through a very responsible agents like organizations like Waste Warriors who are doing a fabulous work on these kind of thing. So managing waste has all these components together which people somehow are not able to appreciate when they see it from outside.